Did you ever wonder how From Software created the beautiful, awe-inspiring, Lovecraftian worlds of Bloodborne or the Dark Souls series? Whether you're traveling through murky sewers or abandoned cities, or scaling cathedral walls, you simply have to stop and absorb the environmental storytelling that simply rocks you to the core. So how did they build this world? We have no idea. We think it's witchcraft, but we'd like to take a more scientific approach here at GDHQ. So we're going to try to build a similar and kind of simpler environment using the base version of Unity 2018.3. Hey guys, this is Al over at GameDevHQ.com, and every week we bring you three pieces of amazing content related to game development. Like and subscribe and check us out at GameDevHQ.com. So this is a scene that we created inspired by a Bloodborne kind of world using assets in Filebase on GameDevHQ.com and using the basic version of Unity 2018.3, which you can download for free. In this tutorial, we're going to introduce terrains, how to lay in trees, and also how to lay in assets from GameDevHQ into your scene. Okay, so to start off, we're going to be doing this in Unity 2018.3. And the first thing we're going to want to do is we're going to create a terrain. So go to Game Object, 3D Object, Terrain. Now, if we go to our scene view, this thing is really big and it stretches forever, all right? Let's do a couple of adjustments right off the bat. First thing I like to do is I like to create a 3D object and drop a cube into my scene, and I like to set it at zero. This gives me a real scale of my game objects right here. And so I know my terrain is, of course, on this corner and stretched into oblivion. So we're just going to do some quick adjustments to that. If we click on this terrain settings tool and we go down here to the mesh resolution. So I'm going to decrease my length of my terrain a little bit from 500 to 250. I'm also going to select my terrain and I'm going to set my position at -250. So that would move it all the way over to that side. So let's do 125 and then a -125 as well. So now my terrain is in the center and my cube sits dead center here. Now we're going to want to keep our detail resolution a little higher just because we may get into trouble if we don't. So let's go to 64. So with my terrain kind of set right now, and just a good practice is always make your terrain a lot bigger than what you expect to use in your scene. For me in this instance, I know this scene's gonna be kind of small, so I'm okay with this, but it's always better to be too big versus too small in this situation. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start bringing in assets from GDHQ, and everything we do is going to use GDHQ assets. If you are a member of GDHQ, all you have to do is go to Filebase, and we have assets by the dozens in here. So one of the assets I'm gonna look at are the Crypt and the Tombstones. And all you would really have to do once you are a member is just click on Crypt and hit download, and you'll be able to download it into your folder. And then once you've downloaded it, it comes with an actual Unity Crypt package. So you just take this, drop it into your project, and it will create your GDHQ Filebase library in here. So if I scroll into my urban in my crypt, I have my crypt ready to go right here. So all I have to do is take it and drop it into scene, and there's my crypt. So from here, I'm just going to kind of assume that this one's going to sit right over here. So I'm just gonna turn off my high LOD version right here. So it'll be the low LOD. And I'm kind of will just build my scene around this crypt. So, and I may actually add a secondary crypt. Let's say one right over here. So I'll have two crypts in this scene. And then I can go to my terrain tool and use my brush. And in here, there's a drop-down menu, and you can create neighbor terrains, raise or lower terrains, etc., etc. We're going to use the raised terrain right now. And you see how intense this currently sits right here. We want to bring this intensity far further down. So this is a 2, so we'll just go for a 1 at this point. And you see how I'm just slightly increasing the height of the terrain. So I'm going to do this kind of all around the crypt. I'm going to do it around the back. And I'm going to create a pathway for the crypt to occur. So the pathway will go right here. And then the next pathway for the crypt will occur right there. And I'll have this kind of center hill where we'll put more tombstones into it. And then I'm going to increase the size of the brush. And I'm just going to raise the height of the areas around the crypt. And then behind this, I'm going to raise it even more. So I get these nice rolling hills that sit behind my scene. And let me go ahead and smooth this a little bit. And if you hold shift while you're doing it, you can actually lower down some hills. So you have some room to play here. And then I think this will look pretty darn good at this point. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this cube now that I got my crypts into my scene. So with these crypts now, I'm going to make sure that I set these to static. And setting them to static is a really important thing. It's going to turn on the baking down here in the bottom right. But then it means that there's going to be less that has to be drawn dynamically. And it's always a good idea to just get comfortable with baking static objects, objects that are not moving around in your scene. So the next thing I'm going to want to do is I want to click terrain, and I want to start adding in some trees into my scene. So if I go to my vegetation, those environments, in urban, I have this old tree prefab right here, and you can see it right there, and I can drop it into scene, and there it is, and I'm just going to reset this to 0, so it sets back right here, and I'm just going to increase the size. I want to get a good idea of what size to make this tree next to this crypt. And I think this is a pretty good amount right here. Now, on this is a script that allows for a level of detail to occur. Now, what an LOD is inside of each one of these, there's a different 3D object. When you're at 100% or you're really close, you're at the 100% view of this tree. But as you slowly zoom back, you could see that the camera's moving back further. When I cross that threshold of 75%, the actual model changes. And I don't know if you could actually see the swap, but we go from a really high density version of the tree, and you could see it in the shadow, to a lower version density of the tree. And then when I get to 41%, I swap it for a different version of the tree that's even lower in polygons. And you can actually adjust the levels at when you want to see this tree occur. And that way you get a good example of when it is that it's obvious that you switch trees versus not. Once you have this tree in, go to your terrain, go to your tree tools, and it's gonna say, you know, to click paint trees, etc., etc. So we need to add our tree. So click edit tree, add tree. Inside, we're gonna need to assign our tree. So we're gonna wanna grab our prefab and drop it into the tree and hit add. Now that we've done that, we can decrease the brush size, because it's just, if we drop it in like that, it's gonna paint trees like crazy. And we just wanna kind of spill them in overall. And I'm gonna actually delete this old tree out of the scene so I don't get this confused. And back in my terrain, I could start painting in trees into my scene. Now, if you hit shift, you can go in and delete them. So just kind of go and treat this like an art program and paint in your environment. So this, I believe, is a great place to stop. We have introduced the terrain system. We introduced adding trees onto the terrain. We also showed how to add assets from Filebase into our scene, and we got a great start right here. So check me out next week, and we'll continue on with this tutorial on how to make an environment similar to Bloodborne or the Soul series in Unity. And a special thanks to all the GDHQ Plus and Pro members out there. Your support makes this channel possible. So thank you, and thanks to all the new subscribers out there. I'm Al. I'm out of here. I will catch you next week. Take care.